It has a value in many different dimensions. It has obviously a strong economic value. We are each other's most important partners in trade, in investment, in industrial cooperation, all the rest of it. We are together well over a third of global trade, close to 40% of global trade. That also means that in the economic area, when we work together, that has a projection and an influence on the rest of the world. But the partnership goes much beyond that. There's a security dimension well known throughout the post-war era, with Europe gradually stepping up and taking more responsibility, particularly for out-of-area operations, with the multiplication of EU peace and security missions in Africa and elsewhere. There is a very strong values-based dimension to this. When we talk of the kind of society we want to live in, the kind of society and the freedoms we develop for our people, for our citizens, we talk about the same thing. We don't always interpret it exactly the same way. We have our differences, but we are on the same level. We have the same outlook, and we are the strongest defenders of that order, that vision for the rest of the world. The European Union is a union built on law. We believe in a rules-based order. That is what we've built for ourselves. That is what we want to engage in at the international level. We are strong believers in multilateralism because we are convinced that that is the only sensible way forward in order to find the right compromises, bring everybody on board. We also believe in it because it has shown that it works. It delivers results. That goes very much for the trade area too. The WTO is by no means a perfect organization. It has a lot of weaknesses. It has things that can be corrected. It has things that need to be changed or developed as the international economy develops. But we are strongly convinced that we best do that within the system. There are examples of it. Even now, we know that the US administration has doubts about certain aspects of the WTO. At the same time, the US, the EU, and Japan work very closely together, notably also in a WTO context, to look at how we can confront China with what we believe are some of the economic contradictions in Chinese commercial policy. So that's a good example of how, even in times of challenge, even in times of questioning and difficulties, we can find common ground and take that forward in a multilateral setting. As I said earlier, it is very important because sheer volume, you have no other economic relationship like the one between the EU and the US. And I want to say trade and investment rather than just trade, because the investment is the long-term dimension. It is the strength of confidence and conviction that we will continue to partner, we will continue to work together. Through that, you then also have joint research, joint product development, the gradual meshing of what we do. Through that, we develop common standards or mutual recognition of the standards. So we trust each other. We trust the quality of our respective products. When we can do that together, we de facto set a standard for the world. So the relationship is important for us intrinsically, but is equally important for how we can project and defend our interests towards the rest of the world.